Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to continue our discussion of extended regression models, also called ERMs. This is the second in a series of videos in which I work the example from Intro 8 in the ERM manual. This video will begin where the first video ends, so you will want to watch the first video before you begin this video. In the last video, we learned how to incorporate an endogenous covariate into our ERM using eregress. The estimated coefficients for weight and sex were closer to the true model when we included weight as an endogenous covariate. In this video, I'm going to show you how to deal with non-random treatment assignment. Estimating the average treatment effect would be easy if the employees had been randomly assigned to the wellness program. We could simply calculate the difference between the average weight loss in each group. Any difference between the two groups could be attributed solely to the treatment because the effect of the other covariates would be removed by random assignment. Unfortunately, the employees in our fictional company are not randomly assigned to participate in the wellness program. The employees chose whether to participate or not. Fortunately, we can use the potential outcomes framework to estimate the average treatment effect when treatment is not randomly assigned. We can do this when treatment status is exogenous, meaning that it is only related to other covariates that we measure. And we can also do this when treatment status is endogenous, meaning that it is also related to unobserved factors that affect the outcome. For endogenous treatments, we can include a treatment model that includes covariates that influence the choice to participate in the wellness program or not. For example, older employees may be more likely to participate in the wellness program, so we could include age. We could also include smoking in our treatment model because smoking signals a lower willingness to engage in healthy behaviors. It should be correlated with participation in the program, but smoking status measured before the program was offered should not be independently associated with weight loss during the program. We can incorporate a treatment model into our main model by checking the box next to treatment. Endogenous is already selected by default. Next, we select the treatment variable WellPGM as the dependent variable for our treatment model, and then age and smoking as the independent variables. I'm also going to check the box next to Do Not Interact Treatment with Covariates in the main equation, just to keep the model relatively simple. Next, I'm going to type Estimate Store Entreat so that I can compare the estimated coefficients with my other models. In the ENTREAT model, where we have accounted for the endogeneity of starting weight and the endogenous treatment assignment to the wellness program, we estimate that the effect of participating in the program is about 0.84 kilograms lost. This is closer to the 1.25 kilograms we estimated in the true model than the 1.9 kilograms we estimated in the endogenous model that did not account for treatment assignment. But there is still room for improvement in our model. The lower sample size for our ENTREAT model tells us that some people did not return at the end of the study, so we'll focus on endogenous sample selection in the next video. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.